Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are doing well and studying regularly. See, here a competition is going on. Here, there are three kids, Sonu, Monu and Sahil. They all have some pebbles. They all have been given equal number of pebbles, but of different colors. Sonu has got red pebbles, Monu has got green pebbles and Sahil has got yellow pebbles. They all have to count their pebbles. Whoever will count them first will win. See, Sonu has already started counting. He is counting really fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think Sonu is going to win. Let's go to Monu now. Oh, Monu is not counting. He is doing something else. He is making groups of two pebbles each. Oh, wow, that's a good idea. This method of counting will take only half of the time. Okay, let's go to Sahil now. See, in place of two pebbles, Sahil has made the groups of five pebbles each. Oh, Sahil has counted all his pebbles. He says that he has got 30 pebbles. That's absolutely correct. So, Sahil wins. Counting in group made it very easy for him. He could count really fast. Do you know, today the name of our chapter is also the same. So come, we will also do some practice of counting in groups. Look here children, how many cups are here? We will also count in groups. In the lowest row, there are 4 cups. And in the row above this one, there are 3 cups. So 4 plus 3 equals to 7. And above that row, there are 2 and 1, that is 3 more cups. So 7 plus 3 equals to 10 cups. Wow, it was so easy. See, here we have some pairs of shoes. Each row has 3 pairs of shoes. And there are 3 such rows. So we need to add 3 for 3 times. 3 plus 3 plus 3. Equals to 9 pairs. So, here we have 9 pairs of shoes. Let's do some more practice. See children, here some glasses are arranged in groups. In each group, one glass is kept above the two other. So, 2 plus 1 means 3 glasses in each group. And how many such groups do you see here? Let's count. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here we have 4 such groups. So that means we need to add 3 for 4 times. 3 plus 3 equals to 6. 6 plus 3 equals to 9. And 9 plus 3 equals to 12. So here we have 12 glasses. Children, here we have some pairs of earrings. So, how to make their groups? Look at the first pair. And then below it, we see 2 more pairs. It makes 3 pairs. Similarly, on the right side, we have 3 more pairs. So, 3 plus 3 is 6. In the same way, we can see 2 more such groups of 3 pairs each. So, we have a total of 4 such groups. And thus, we have 12 pairs. Here, come, let's count these bangles now. How many bangles are there in one group? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, each group has 5 bangles. And how many such groups are there? There are 5 groups of bangles. Let's once check if all the groups have 5 bangles. Yes, all the groups have 5 Bengals each. So how many Bengals in total? 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5. So here we have 25 Bengals. Now look at these spoons. Some are facing upwards and some downwards. Let us start with the upper ones. They are 4 in number. And thus 4 spoons below them. That makes a total of 8 spoons. And how many such groups do we see here? 1, 2 and 3. So 8 + 8 + 8, it is 24. So there are 24 spoons. Now let's move further. Now for these pictures, we will not do the counting. We will simply try to guess the number. More or less, let us guess. So first is number of teeth in your mouth. More than 40 or less than 40? Let's see. There are 2 bigger front teeth. On one side, we can see 3 more teeth next to the bigger one. So that makes 4. Then there are 4 more. So that makes a total of 8 on one side. Similarly, there will be 8 teeth on the other side. So that makes 16. In the same way, there will be 16 more teeth on the lower side. So 16 + 16. It will definitely be less than 40. Yes, 32 is less than 40. So our answer is less than 40. Next is the number of seeds in an orange. More than 50 or less than 50? Oh, 50 is a big number for seeds of an orange. If there are 2 or 3 seeds in each slice of orange, even then it will not make a total of 50. So our answer will be less than 50. Now, the next one is number of matchsticks in a matchbox. More than 30 or less than 30? Do we need to do the actual counting? Let's try to guess. It seems they will be more than 30. Number of pencils in your class. More than 45 or less than 45? Suppose there are 30 children in the class and each child brings 2 pencils. Actually, some of them even bring 3 pencils. So the total number of pencils will surely be more than 45. Next is number of spokes in one cycle wheel. More than 20 or less than 20? Number of spokes in one cycle wheel. They seem to be more than 20. So our answer will be more than 20. See children, here a few kids are playing a game. Do you want to know about the game? Each child has to jump 5 times on one leg without falling. If the child is able to jump 5 times on a single leg, then the child will get 1 point. Similarly, if the next child also does it, he will also get 1 point. And in the end, the points of all the children will be counted. And the child with maximum points will win the game. You can also play this game. And in the end, don't just count the points, but also count the number of jumps that you made. Now suppose a child gets 5 points. So can you tell me how many times the child has jumped in all? 1 point for 5 jumps. So what do 5 points mean? 5 points shall mean 5 jumps for 5 times. That means the child has jumped 25 times. Yes. Okay, let's move further. Oh, here is a puzzle. Here again, we will play with numbers. So from where should the counting begin? From 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, match them all. You must have seen such puzzles before also. If not, then ask your elders to find out such puzzles from newspapers or magazines for you. You will enjoy a lot in solving them. Okay kids, you must have also seen numbers written on trees. Can you tell me why these numbers are written on trees? Yes, to count them. And you know, sometimes the number written on a few trees gets erased. See here, the number written on some trees have got erased. So can you help to write them again? See, nothing is written on the first tree. And on the second tree, we see 48. So what should be written on the first one? Yes, 47. And after 48? 49. Then 50. Oh, 51 is already written. So next tree will have 52, then 53, and then 54. So children, today you did a lot of work. You must be feeling tired now and hungry too. So let's talk about something on food now. Oh wow, it looks like a story. And look at its name, The Big Carrot. Let's read it. An old man planted a carrot seed. The carrot grew big and sweet. It grew very, very big. He tried to pull out the carrot, but it did not come out. He quickly called his wife. The old man pulled the carrot leaves and the old woman pulled him. But they could not pull it out. The old woman called her granddaughter. Now the old man, the old woman and the granddaughter tried but could not pull the carrot out. So the granddaughter called the dog. The old man, his wife, the granddaughter and the dog could not pull the carrot out. Then the dog called the cat. Everyone pulled and the cat held on to the dog's tail. The carrot did not move. The cat called the mouse. They all pulled hard together. And the carrot came out. The boom! They all fell down. They were so excited. So they all went to the kitchen to make gajar ka halwa and ate it up. So children, when the old man and the old woman tried to pull the carrot out all alone, they could not do it. But when they all tried it together, they could pull it out so easily. So working in groups is really good. Okay, so let's read it once again. An old man planted a carrot seed. The carrot grew big and sweet. It grew very, very big. He tried to pull out the carrot, but it did not come out. He quickly called his wife. The old man pulled the carrot leaves and the old woman pulled him. But they could not pull it out. The old woman called her granddaughter. The old man, the old woman and the granddaughter tried but could not pull the carrot out. The granddaughter called the dog. The old man, his wife the granddaughter and the dog could not pull the carrot out. Then the dog called the cat. Everyone pulled and the cat held on to the dog's tail. The carrot did not move. The cat called the mouse. They all pulled hard together and the carrot came out. Zaboom! They all fell down and they were so excited. So they all went to the kitchen to make gajar ka halwa and ate it up. Okay children, now look at this picture and answer some questions. How many are pulling the carrot out? So, can you count them all? Start from the old man. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So, there are 6 people. So, 6 people are pulling the carrot out. So, the next question is, who was the first one to pull it? We all know that old man was the first one to pull it. Next, the cat is dash in the line. So tell me, at which number is the cat? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The cat is fifth in the line. Who was the fourth one to pull the carrot? So see, who is standing before the cat? How many were pulling the carrot before the cat came to help them? That's easy. You just need to count them. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, make a cap on the third one in the line. Oh, that's quite interesting. Make a mustache for the sixth one in the line. You will enjoy that too. See children, Seema has made a design with different types of dots. Look at the different groups of dots carefully. All the dots are of different color and different design. Let's count them all. How many dots are there in the first group? 4 in the top row, then 3, then 2 and 1, that is 3. So 4 plus 3 plus 3, that is 10 dots. Now let's count the dots in the next group. Its shape is also similar to the first one. So maybe it also has 10 dots. Let's count. 4 plus 3 plus 2 and 1. Yes, here also we have 10 dots. So now let's look at the next group. Oh, it also has 10 dots. I think they all have 10 dots. Okay, so let's count how many such groups are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here we have 7 groups. So how many dots in all? Adding 10 for 7 times, we get 70. So here we have 70 dots. See children, counting each dot one by one would have taken a lot of time. But counting in groups had made it so easy. Isn't it? Okay, can you tell me, to get a total of 100 dots, how many more dots do we need to make? Or how many groups of 10 dots each? Here we have 70 dots. So to get a total of 100, we will need 30 more dots. So tell me, how many groups of 10 each? Very good. 3 more groups need to be made. Okay children, now let's have a look at some questions. First is, Here is the first picture. To get a total of 10 balls, how many more balls need to be made? Now see here. To make a group of 10 trees, how many more trees should we make? Now in this picture here, how many groups of balls are there? And how many balls does each group have? So, how many balls are there in all? Very good. It was fun. So, children, now we will meet in the next lesson. Thank you. Have a nice day.